decades after the fall of the Berlin Wall, the Pentagon realized that deploying megaton-yield gravity bombs over Europe, the highest level nuclear weapons in U.S. inventory, was not just unlikely, but utterly inconceivable. Thus, these stout nuclear weapons were now regarded as relics of the Cold War. However, the new millennium required a new type of nuclear weapon, and the B-61 nuclear bomb was given a new spin. After years of development, the B-61-12 weapon was tested in 2020 and captured on camera by the Sandia National Labs as it successfully dropped from an F-15E Strike Eagle and into the ground. Model 12 is said to provide more control over the uncontrollable, and the Air Force is now seeking to upgrade several models of stealth fighters for enhanced nuclear strike roles, including the F-35A Lightning II. This exceedingly expensive program has suffered major setbacks during the last few months, but delivering thermonuclear weapons with more effective American models continues to be a way into the future, maximizing the potential of nuclear warfare in the world. The B-61-12 program started in 2010. The Mod 12 upgrade of the B-61 nuclear bomb was born out of the need for a forward-deployed tactical strategic nuclear weapon that could protect NATO and Asian allies. The bomb can be used from dual-capable fighter aircraft, so the plan is to arm F-35s and B-21 Raiders with it. Furthermore, its lower yield options give it a more flexible range of operations with significantly less collateral damage. In fact, it would push aside the last megaton yield bomb and become the only American gravity nuclear bomb. Nevertheless, at the beginning of the aircraft compatibility testing in 2013, the Pentagon stated that if refurbishment of the B-61 did not begin by 2019, its components might decay. Consequently, Congress slashed its funding and advocated for alternative options. Former Air Force Chief of Staff Norton A. Schwartz argued that the new mod had the potential to enhance accuracy while lowering yield, reducing fallout compared to previous versions. Accuracy had not proved a guarantee for airdropped weapons, and generous warheads had to compensate to effectively impact a target. The experts claimed that increasing accuracy significantly improved a weapon and amplified its potential targets simultaneously. However, several critics disputed that more accurate but less destructive weapons would make leaders drop their caution about deploying them. Schwartz disagreed and asserted that it would actually deter adversaries because the U.S. would be more prone to deploying such weapons. Mod 12 ended up being a refurbishment of four previous variants, and its first test flights commenced in 2015. That November, the bomb proved an effective earth penetrator with reduced radioactive fallout risk, making it increasingly appealing to the military. The Mod 12 extension program continued through 2018, when two successful, albeit non-nuclear, system qualification flight tests were achieved at Tinopah Test Range. By October, its guided tail kit assembly, featuring an inertial navigation system, received Milestone C approval and entered the production phase. In under 11 months, the assembly achieved a 100% success rate after 31 bomb drops, and after considerable ground testing, test flights, modeling, and simulated flights, readiness was finally verified. A B-61-12 bomb with non-nuclear and mock nuclear components was then examined during flight tests with the U.S. Air Force and the F-15E in early 2020. Footage taken by Sandia National Labs shows the bomb dropping from above 25,000 feet and taking almost a full minute before hitting its target. Ground crews then analyzed telemetry data from before and after the drop, including arming, fire, and timing metrics. B-61-12 Systems Manager Steve Samuels conveyed that, quote, "We've collected the data to date. It looks like everything functioned as designed, and it was a very successful test. It demonstrated the final qualification points and evidence for the nuclear certification of the F-15E Strike Eagle." Several other aircraft are now trying to achieve certification, and the process to fully certify the F-35A for a nuclear strike role made significant progress in 2021. Armed with the B-61-12, the objective is for the aircraft to carry weapons in a real-world operation in the coming years. A full weapon system demonstration took place on September 21st, in which two conventional takeoff and landing F-35As dropped a single unarmed Mod 12 over the Tonopah Test Range in Nevada. As photographs released by the Air Force show, The so-called graduation test was carried out by the 422nd and 59th Test and Evaluation Squadrons stationed at Nellis Air Force Base. The F-35 Joint Program Office stated that each weapon was dropped at different altitudes and speeds, although exact parameters were not revealed. However, it is known that at some point in the recent past, at least one F-35A dropped a Mod 12 at supersonic speed. After a total of 10 test drops, the Air Force completed the flight test portion of the nuclear design certification process for the 12th version of the B-61 series. Now the program has been cleared to move into the operational certification phase, or in other words, take the weapon to frontline service. As explained by Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Jackson, quote, "The B-61 series weapons are tactical gravity nuclear weapons that can be used on dual-capable aircraft like the F-15E and F-16CD. Having a fifth-generation DCA fighter aircraft with this capability brings an entirely new strategic-level capability that strengthens our nation's nuclear deterrence mission." In 2017, the Air Force set a goal to introduce the B-61-12 capability on the F-35 between 2020 and 2022. However, the first production is not expected until 2022. Furthermore, the specialized capability will be realized by earmarked units, likely with F-16s currently deployed in Europe. Beyond hardware and software updates, the transition would require appropriate training of air crews and maintainers. Additionally, it would be necessary to upgrade infrastructure for support and security regarding the new mission. It is expected that not only will the U.S. Air Force execute nuclear strike missions, but also NATO allies. By now, several friendly countries have purchased the F-35A, like Belgium and the Netherlands, and it is likely that they will be given access to American nuclear bombs if necessary. Currently, the Air Force is more interested in promoting the F-35A in its new role as a strategic weapons delivery platform, as well as a tactical strike asset. It is believed that by combining the increased accuracy of the B-61-12's precision guidance system with the aircraft's outstanding stealth capabilities, it will be possible to attack better defended targets. In fact, its improved capabilities will allow the aircraft to launch the weapon dozens of miles away from its target, thus increasing survivability. And in addition, its combat radius is more significant in contrast with other tactical fighters. Ultimately, the B-61-12 was designed to be carried by both strategic and tactical platforms, that is, bombers and fighters. Lieutenant Colonel Douglas A. Cable expressed, quote, "It makes our potential adversaries think more about their game plan before launching it. The F-35A can get closer to, further inside, a combat area that may otherwise be impossible for non-stealth assets." Incidentally, the F-35A would not be working alone. With the support of the nuclear-capable B-2 stealth bomber, the combined attributes would be key to defeating enemy air defenses. The program has unfortunately suffered significant delays, not to mention cost increases. Its $10 billion price tag ultimately proved too costly, as the average cost per bomb unit is about $27.5 million, and that figure doesn't even consider any unforeseen circumstances. Still, the integration process is progressing smoothly, but there are still many considerations to be added before the new weapon is deployed to the front line. B-6112 systems manager Stephen Samuels is hopeful about the future and claims that the F-35A was equipped not only to, quote, "successfully execute a test," but also successfully execute a mission.